So that's how a regular palooka goes from cabbie to mob enforcer overnight, is it? Just dumb luck?
Didn't feel that way at the time. Me parking on that particular street, taking a break just when Polly and Sam are coming around the corner, what are the odds? I felt like, I don't know, like someone was watching out for us.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, pal, but it's a lucky break all the same. I mean, one day you're busting your back, doing an honest day's work in a city that's been trying to scrape you off its heels since the day you stepped off the boat, and the next you're stuffing your pockets full of Salieri's dirty money and lording it over the rest of us.
Yeah, it wasn't like that. Back then, Salieri didn't have the run of the city. For every buck Salieri made, Don Morello would turn 10. He paid off cops, politicians, judges, and anyone he couldn't buy, he scared into looking the other way.
He did seem to have the city jumping at its own shadow, I'll give you that.
You hear anything about Joey Crackers?
Yeah, got his name in the Morello file, sure. Boxer, right?
Yeah, that's the guy.
Ah, what's up, lads? Cast and Crowl here.
We are here.
It's a weird place to start.
Joey was
off.
Just driving to the gym one morning.
Ah.
Probably daydreaming about winning a belt or something.
God damn it! Moron! You're driving with your goddamn eyes closed! Look at this! Jesus, Mary, Joseph, Tom Morello, I didn't know it was you.
You know anybody else driving a rare import in this part of town, Joey?
No. Well, then, I'm sorry, I was driving real slow.
You're saying this is my fault?
No, sir. I ain't never been in no accident.
Well, repairs are gonna be expensive.
Oh, you're not gonna need that, sir. The tires are just fine. The grill's a little bent up, is all. I mean, I got a cousin, I got...
Ruthless. Oh.
Someone spun you a tail, pal. You got an informant right there, says Morello made a mint every time Crackers went to the mat.
That's true, too. And still, Morello left that poor sap dead in the street. Head all caved in.
Don't square.
Well, maybe the Don knew Joey's career was on the downhill. Maybe he was trying to scare some other guy into paying up. Who knows? Don Salieri chalked it up to Morello not being able to think straight when he was mad.
You, have any more run-ins with Morello's crew back then?
Not at first. For a couple of years after I joined up, things were quiet. We got into a few dust-ups with guys trying to muscle in, but elsewise it was just the usual routine. We're running booze, offering protection. Me and the boys doing rounds to collect small time. But I ain't gonna lie. Most days, we was also having a bit of fun.
A bit of fun, eh? Oh, man. This is gonna be the third episode, and damn, I'm gonna have to make more Spider-Man episodes. Fair play! Jesus, 32, huh? Damn.
Tommy, thanks for getting down here so quickly.
Yeah, sure thing, boss. What do you need?
You know, there's a race coming up.
Oh, yeah. Polly and Sam have some money on the local.
Mikey Dunn.
That's the guy.
He's a good kid, but a bit of a scrapper. Not too smart with his money. A few years ago, Mikey comes to me asking for a loan. He wants to get new tires so he can keep racing junkers out at the quarry. I like fast cars. I figure it'll be a bit of a hobby. Turns out, Mikey's a great investment. The kid can't lose a race if he walks the track. He graduates from the junkers to gouge-jobs, and I start placing a few bets on him here and there. Next thing I know, I've made all my money back and more.
Hey, Sam says he's the guy to beat.
He was. We ran all the competition out of town. But now Ralph says there's a hotshot European entering the race. And he's got a car faster than our boys by a country mile.
How much do we stand to lose?
A truckload. But not just our outfit. A lot of guys from the neighborhood come to me for financial advice. They've all put money down on this kid. It'll be like Black Thursday around here if he loses. Well, for everyone except Morello.
Oh, you think he's from the European?
Oh, I'm certain of it.
You want something to happen to the driver?
Can't find him. Morello's got him holed up somewhere safe. Besides, if he drops out or disappears now, none of our wagers will stand. Everyone will cry foul, say the race is fixed.
What about his car?
That's the ticket, Tommy. Ralph knows a guard at the track. You go down there tonight, you boost the European's car, bring it to one of our mechanics, and make a few adjustments, you bring the car back.
Should be no problem, boss.
Sarah, can I get a drink here? As soon as you're ready.
Sure thing.
All right.
Your pop letting you out for the race.
Our first night mission.
Feels like we're packing our place up and moving it to the stand.
Oh, hello. Race day approaches. The grandest day in the sporting calendar is almost upon us. Record crowds are expected to descend upon the Lost Heaven Autodrome this weekend as the city basks in glorious sunshine. Famous German driver Martin Lichtenberg has taken some time away from the International Series to challenge Lost Haven's hero, Mike Dunn. And racing fans are on tenterhooks. Cool. Anyways.
Look at this half portion.
Hello.
Where were you last night?
I was with you.
You go on ahead, Tom. I'll deal with this mook. Polly, he drove you home.
Damn.
Oh, yeah. Christ, that was some night.
I bet
for
so.
You, maybe. But those broads, not so much.
Hey, buonasera, Tom.
Anyways.
So that's a five.
That's good, boy.
Hey, Titty Tommy. Big day coming up, right? You seen the race before?
Kind of hard to miss. Celieri isn't going to let Morello break his winning streak, huh?
No, sir. Gotta send him a message. So, tonight, we borrow his guy's motor from the track. My friend Bobby is a guard. For a little dough, he'll show you where it is, then look someplace else while you turn the key.
I like Bobby already.
Sure. Then there's this other guy, Lucas Bertone. You take the car to him down under the Giuliano Bridge. He'll, you know, tune it a little. Make the race tomorrow more interesting.
Then I take the car straight back and Bobby can stop looking someplace else.
But you gotta be quick. Bobby comes off shift at 1:30 and then the next guy, he's an ass.
Oh, man.
Oh, hey,
I love that line.
If you need somewhere to keep your motor safe where no one can take them, feel free to use the garage. Carlo finally got around to clearing it out.
Thanks.
Okay. So, let's select ourselves a vehicle. Anyways, last episode. Well, what should I say? That we are here. Might as well take it out. I believe we started off with, taking revenge on the boys who destroyed our cab. And after that, we did another mission where we just did collections and it just got interesting.
Yeah, I got trouble.
Officers in trouble. Assistance needed immediately.
We got him!
Go away. Man. Yeah, finished some collections, and near the end, Tommy got a little taste of the real Martin jobs and shit. Apparently he's thought of, which he didn't. Slow stuff. Oh, that's a second copper over there. Yeah, just gonna take some time in. Life sucks. Can you go away? Did you try to pit maneuver me? Oh, you sad. Pretty sure you... Hunter City. I wonder if it's... Actually, no, definitely not. The AI is very challenging. Let's just say that. Also, let's see if there's going to be any more graphical errors. Not graphical errors, but... texture... glitches. And I'm not seeing one now.
You Bobby. Yep. We can take your car to the garage. Place is empty.
Any friend of Ralphie's a friend of mine.
I mean, if you got the money, sure.
So...
tomorrow morning they start coming. Whole city. They smuggle in hooch. There's fighting. I hate it.
Ah, come on. Name a better place to pick up a dame than this place this weekend.
Don't get me started. Things I've seen.
Anyways. I don't know why, but my friends would play through this. The water texture... it's not right. It's like a big blurry texture that's going through the road. Extends all the way through here particularly, and then just stops, like, here on here. Or it's back there. It's a weird. And it's weird that it's not even here. Because I don't think there's a patch in general. At least from when I purchased it. It's like the most... patch. Oh, no, hold on. Yeah, I'm gonna have
what does the president
here.
Have?
Okay, this is it.
Yeah? Oh, number four. Okay. Oh!
Here she is. 1929 Carrizella C Series. Best in class. It's a shame you gotta wreck it.
If they see this down the road, cops are gonna ask questions.
When they catch up, sure. Try to keep it one piece too, huh?
So, I gotta be back from Bertone by 1:30 before the next guy shifts.
Yeah.
Oh, he's an ass. Listen to that.
I heard.
Okay. So, man. Three war cars, and they keep on saying, feel like my next new love after three war civilian cars in general. Oh god. But, we saw it going bad. Oh man. Since this is a wet road, I gotta be careful. Okay. Just quick. Oh god. Oh man. Oh man. I'm trying to get it back. Ooh, that's gonna be a bigger problem for me. Oh my god. I managed to squeeze through. I'm happy about that. Speed! And power like Jeremy Clark in that scene. In that scene. Oh, speed and braking power. Braking powers. Oh shit, that's awful. You know what I'm going on that. No, 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 no. Oh, God. That would have taken out my duo. At least, I don't know. Ooh, God. Get out of here. Also, this looks like a Bugatti Type 35. I'm pretty sure that's just specific. I feel like that's a specific inspiration for this car, but I know there's others like the Alpine cars. Oh god. Also, we can do damage with this car. Hell yeah. Oh, there's a car over there. Oh, God. Go ahead and head it out. Of course, I'm going to the garage.
Tommy Angelo.
Lucas Bertone. Oh, ain't she a thing of beauty?
We don't have much time.
Hey, I'm a fast worker. Sit tight. Hello, you.
Back before anyone catches on.
Go easy with her. She's gonna misbehave. Hey, tell Mr. Salieri I'm always available for this kind of work. I do stuff for a lot of people, but I always know where I stand with you guys. Hot cars, getaways, anything for the right price.
Let's just hope Salieri's guy wins tomorrow. For all our sakes.
Okay. Drive careful.
Man, I like the detail of Tommy trying to get the key, but kid keeps on talking. Anyways. A little slower. It'll chug a little bit. And there's a temperature gauge thing. Aw, oh, man. You basically fucked over the compression of the car, right? And also the steering's fucked too. Oh, there's a suicide about to happen. Someone fighted. A fight he had at the bridge, bro. Damn. Alright. Hopefully I can sit safe. Oh my God. The twitching of the steering is no bueno. And here too, the throttle response is fucked as well. No. Oh, God damn it. Oh, my God. Fuck off. I'm trying to do something important, yes? Purse. Oh my God, what was that? What was that little red turn for, you dumbass? God, I would shoot right now, but the timer there. Thankfully, this is kind of much easier to control. But the twitching. Oh my God. Okay, no more time. Cool. Right. Yeah.
Christ.
Damn
good
right.
To go. Drives like a jalopy.
Okay, let's get out of here. Big day tomorrow.
Damn right. Oh.
So Sam walks out of the bathroom, and I'm praying he's got a piece on him, because I'm not sure the bartender's going to hand over what he owes. And his two sons, they're inching closer. I can hear them cracking their knuckles. They're both 7 feet tall, built like brick shit houses.
What were you carrying?
My dick.
That's right. This crazy bastard, he waltzes out of the bathroom, just starts pissing all over the joint.
Really? What, he didn't call the cops?
Nah, sometimes you just gotta make them think you're crazy.
Tom, you got the moment? Oh.
Jeffrey,
we've got a bit of a situation.
Is the boss okay?
Oh, yeah, it's nothing like that. Mikey Dunn, our driver. Some of Morello's guys roughed him up pretty good last night. Broke his arm, broke his jaw. Sent him to the hospital.
Jesus.
Yeah, tough luck for Mikey. Anyway, you're going to race for him.
Wait, what? Frank,
Tom,
I don't...
It's a half hour before the starting gun goes off, so this is not a discussion. But Don wants to win. But more importantly, he wants Morello to lose. And you are our best wheelman. Otherwise, I'd be talking to someone else.
Yeah. Okay, Frank.
Good. Rafi has the car gassed and ready. Get to the track right away.
Oh, it's the big day, but it's for me.
From Europe, we got the hotshot favorite, Martin Lichtenberg, taking some time out of the International Series to compete with us today.
Actually, I think all the...
Got some news from the grid here. Lost Heaven local favorite Mikey Dunn is out. Replacing him is, Tommy Angelo. Well, I'm sure you'll all join me in wishing him good luck.
Godspeed. I don't like my rims, but whatever.
They're lined up on the grid. They're ready to start. They're off.
All right.
Lichtenberg's in trouble. There's something up with his car. Lichtenberg is out.
Yep, and there he is. I think all that matters is that we cross the finish line.
Who's going to survive the Lost Heaven Circuit?
Oh god, oh god, oh god. Oh man, I don't even get into this. Okay, so we've got three laps. The only challenging part, I think, is that turn there, right after the starting line, and the chicane, which I don't think is coming up now.
With Lichtenberg no longer a contender,
oh, look at that.
Jostling for position.
Oh, man. Oh, 11th place. Look at that. Alright, this turn actually... what is that? The chicane's coming up, though. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother with racing this one in general. Oh, damn it, I lost the place. No way. There shouldn't be two down. I just was wishing that I don't spin up. Alright. Straight away, and of course I have to... To check the U-turn.
Are these the final podium places, or is it someone else's time to shine?
Jesus!
Some rough racing out there. Hopefully nothing serious. Take the
chances
of Angelo. All still in the mix, with time still left to go.
No! Oh my god! fucking hell, man.
Garcia, Lewis, and Jackson are pushing ahead toward the front of the field.
I'm at the back of the field. This sucks proper.
Lichtenberg's exit really has thrown this race out wide. They all smell victory.
Okay, I'm just gonna...
Son of a bitch!
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Oh my god, can I please just spawn in? Please. So I can take over that shit. Chicane. I don't care. Get my ass line. Dialogue at least.
The new driver, Tommy Angelo, is near the front with no sign of losing position.
Oh, God. I would talk about getting out, but I don't like to spin around and lose everything like before. Nice. Ain't that good scripting. Oh, this is still medium, by the way. I just changed the driving simulation that's just like driving experience, whatever. Fuck yeah! God damn, that was...
Hey, Tommy! There's our winner!
Hey, Tom. Just want to thank you for stepping in like you did. I had 6 months rent riding on that race. I'd be homeless now if not for you.
I just did what the Don asked, Lucas.
Well, you gotta let me find a way to repay you. Stop by my garage when you get a chance. I might have a line on something that'll turn a buck for you.
Sure. Thanks.
I knew you wouldn't let us down, Tom. You made us all a lot of money today. And Morello's gonna be picking up pennies off the sidewalk for weeks.
Hey, what about the European?
He's probably wearing cement boots by now, the poor bastard. Here. You earned every dollar of this. Take your girl out somewhere nice.
Thanks, boss.
You got a girl, right? I don't want you blowing all that on booze and whores.
Something, huh? Cheers.
Nah, but, maybe I'll buy my mom a new coat.
Good boy. Go get yourself a drink.
Congratulations, big hero.
Yeah, I just got lucky's off.
Well, I had my money on the other guys, so... Drinks are on you.
Oh.
There. Now you're ready for the pictures.
Thanks.
And hey, when you're done celebrating, you might want to go find your buddy, Polly. He's so drunk, he's gonna get hit by a parked car.
Yeah, okay. I'll get him home safe.
Bad. Gonna get hit by a parked car, huh? Hello, Vinny.
You're a natural wheel man, Tom.
You seen Polly anywhere, Vin?
He said he was gonna go eat to soak up the boots. But I never seen cannolis come that big.
Uh-huh.
That's all for another
also,
year,
I
folks.
Hear some hits.
Track will be open until 6. Please
there might
leave
be something
when requested.
Going on here. Let's take a look. Oh, hey, there's something here. Cigarette cards, Marino. Ah, and... There's the foreigner getting his ass beat by Marilla's men. Damn. Oh. Don't know why you're beating his ass. His car fucking died. And we know why. Oh. You're such epic bastards. Right, hello.
Polly and the rest of your pals have drunk through half my bar already. You found him yet?
I wish. Actually, I feel like this might be the only mission in this episode, so, yeah.
Yuma made that look easy to Tatami. When they started racing here 20 years ago, most guys didn't even make the finish.
Ah, magic's in the motor, Ralph. I just showed him where to go. Hey, you seen Polly?
Don't know. He said he was hungry or something.
Okay. You enjoy yourself.
Sure will, Tom. Thanks.
Grazie, Frankie. I saw some Marvel.
That's we in the just put my daughter through another year at school, Tom.
Hey, anything for the Coletti's.
Well, enjoy the moment. But the deal with Polly before he embarrasses himself and the family. I will not let the boss's day end sourly.
You don't have to worry, Frank.
All right. Oh, it's the Italian song. It's the pizza song. I don't know if you can hear it. Who's that guy over there?
This your first time at the track?
Last year I heard the motors from my apartment, but that's as close as I've gotten before.
Oh, hey.
How'd you drive after the tuna?
Tried to go sidelong at a 5-brick walls, but we made it. You seen Polly any place?
Came by 5 minutes ago, maybe. Looked like it had a smell from the barrel.
Sounds about right. Thanks, Lucas.
Grazie. What is this? Ah, Dying Detective. Second one gun. Okay, so it's playing.
Great race, champ.
Various Italian music.
Hey! Last time I saw you drive like that, Tom, I had a gun to your head.
You saying there wasn't one today?
When our side of town is drowning in dough, that means you're safe. Hey, you seen Polly? Guy soused. Came through walking sideways.
Yeah, I heard.
Alright, well, I'm still trying to find him. Oh, it's coming from them, huh?
I'd ask again that people please leave when requested and refrain from imbibing illicit substances. Let's not make it like last year, folks.
Shut up. Oh, hi. Where's that? Hello.
Oh, thank Christ you're here.
Oh,
it's
a dude.
If your friend keeps this up, the other guy's gonna send the cops over.
Yeah, I think Polly's big day at the track's over.
Okay. Come on, Polly. Don't make the Italian music go sour. Yeah. Oh, God.
And the chicken says quack. What does the bird say?
I don't know, but the security guy back there says you gotta go home.
Guy's an asshole. You should show some respect.
Well, that's true, but I'm saying you gotta go home, too, before you resurface the pit lane.
Well, okay, then. I guess.
Let's go, Jim.
Jesus Christ, boy. All right. Let's get your ass here. Right. How much we do it already?
You did real good today, Tommy, with the driving. I was right. I was right when I found you. You know what I said?
So let's turn it back to realistic. This one out. There you go, driving up.
What did you say, Polly?
I said this guy can drive. Don Salieri. This is a guy who can drive.
And here we are.
Here we are. Right here. That's where we are.
This car is so tight with my turn. And this is
what I'm doing.
Here I can feel like I'm understanding the way.
Some kind of race car driver. Damn.
We all got our...
You're doing real good since you joined the family, but you know you got it easy, right? Me and Sam, we keep the real stuff from you.
That right, huh?
You don't know what it's like. You get the call to see the Don and your mind's racing. Then some bad shit, Tom.
We're all in this together. I do what the Don asks when he asks. Just like you.
Oh like my god. Me,
you can't just oh. shut it down.
Oh.
Wank it out like Sam does. Go home to. Whatever the hell he goes home to.
Polly, you're drunk. You're gonna have to clam up for your own sakes.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Well, whatever.
Tom, I wanna go with the lady. I'm not helping you with that.
No,
today.
No. That's wrong with you, boy.
Take me to the Blue Tropics.
Oh my god.
You make me feel even worse.
No, that car just fucking turned out of nowhere.
I don't know. I ought to take you home. The bridge. Take the bridge over the island. Take me to the ladies. Take me to those sweet patooties.
Oh, did that NPC just disappear?
I don't know. Taking you home seems more classy.
Exactly.
Bring me home.
Oh, what the hell? What is that noise? Yeah. What the fuck is happening?
Okay, I'm gonna.
Sweet dreams, tough guy.
I'm gonna. Yeah.
I don't know what's happening.
I don't feel so good.
I don't feel so good, sir. Oh, man. Fair play. Chapter done. Oh, God. I legit don't know what the fuck happened there. Yeah, I think I gotta have to cut out that cop chase. Sarah! Oh, man. Oh, God.
Yeah, that's the cold thumb. You want anything else?
Nah, I'm heading home.
Hey, Tom, before you go, I ask maybe a small favor.
Sure, Luigi, what do you need?
Welcome my daughter home.
Sarah? Way I hear it, she doesn't need any kind of escort.
she's a tough. There's this pack of boys near her place. They're punks, you know, cattivi ragazzi. They talk blue, make advances. Sarah, she's gonna speak the mind. But maybe she says something they don't like. Things get ugly. But if you working at home, this will remind that he's punk, she's the Don's a goddaughter.
No problem, Luigi. I'd be honored.
Benny. Sarah, the time is close.
What's this then?
Tom's gonna take you.
Is that right?
Hey, I just work here.
Make sure nobody bother you.
Fine. If it'll make you feel better, Pop.
Hey.
I'll see you tomorrow. Let me get my coat.
I'll wait for you outside. You okay?
I don't need anyone walking me home.
Hey, God damn. You were talking about meeting up tonight anyway.
Anyways, let me check the footage.
What about those punks, Tom?
In general. What about the punks? Nothing? Okay. I guess.
Quit
worrying about
okay.
What he's gonna think.
Not the
so you
point,
just
Tom.
Stop if I...
He treats me like a kid that. Sometimes.
Hey, I get it. He's protective. He's seen things.
We've all seen things.
Don't know about you.
You know, we gotta talk about you stealing food.
Hey, I cook it, so I get to say where it goes.
Wally won't thank you.
Well, maybe tomorrow's finally gonna be the day he fixes his own breakfast.
Damn. Okay.
Could you knock on the door?
Who's
only
this?
Got so many hands here.
Sure. Hello?
Sarah!
Oh, my God.
That for me?
Yeah, though it's not as much as last time.
It's enough. Nona thinks you're an angel.
The Don hates seeing food go to waste.
And this? This has gotta be Tammy. Sarah told us all about you.
That right?
Yeah, not Irish.
You're a famous race driver, Tom. Everyone talks about you.
Yeah, she's right. They do.
Okay.
Well, anyways, don't let the cold in, Juliet. I'll see you at church.
All right. Have a great evening.
That was awkward as hell.
Buena noche, Tommy.
Hey, Mama.
Goodbye. Cool. So this
nice you do that.
Too long,
that?
But
well, I don't know a lot of hungry people on this block.
Yeah.
The current episode.
Well, it's it's a good night for a walk anyway.
Oh yeah.
Don't get yourself killed on my account, Tom.
Nope.
Oh shit.
That's all you got? You spend all this time with a lady killer like Sam Trapani, and the best line you got is good night for a walk anyways?
Well, it is, ain't it?
Yeah, I guess
can
so.
Can you walk slower, though? What?
Flowers for the lady, Signora?
No.
Nah, we're good.
Oh.
Now I don't get flowers?
When you let me take you on a real date and not some walk home for Luigi. Then you get the flowers.
Yeah, that could happen. If Pop's not gonna stop me seeing one of yous. I think he knows anyway.
Luigi? Nah.
These guys have been creeps to me for weeks. But I didn't tell you as I know what you like. I mentioned it to Dad this one time and all of a sudden he gets you to be my knight in shining armor. So yeah, he knows.
Huh. Well, like I say, means there's no problem with me.
If he did, you wouldn't last long. I know what happened to all the other guys I dated. I helped hide the bodies.
Oh, damn.
So now we are.
I've been trying to keep you safe, Tommy Angelo. All this time.
Let's go someplace. Tomorrow night, maybe. The pictures, maybe. You can get your flowers.
That'd be good.
Okay.
Oh! Hey there, darling! Are you stepping out on us?
Piss off.
Don't cast the kitten doll face.
We'll let your boyfriend watch. What do you say?
We going to have trouble here.
Trouble started back when you tried to steal our girl, Chief.
You saps aren't careful. You'll end up in wooden overcoats. Last chance to walk away.
We ain't frails. We know who you work for. Salieri might have been the big six when he was younger, but he's all washed up now. Mm-hmm. It's only a matter of time before Morello punches his ticket.
I don't need Salieri. Or anyone else. Not for this.
Well,
then let's see what you got, cake eater. Mm.
Cake eater, okay. Damn it. Wrong fucking button.
Billy Trey.
Oh.
Get away from me.
Oh.
Twist like
no, give me the pipe.
Get him, Billy.
Those pins go all the way up, huh? Damn it.
You even touched me. You're dead. You're wasting time
with a deadbeat like that. There you go.
I'm not
dead.
Okay.
Open him up. Let's see some blood.
All right, go away. Damn! Crazy. Damn it. Yeah, it's literally just dodging. Punch out, I guess. Alright.
Get away from her!
Oh!
Nah! Nah, I won't!
Oh, in the dick! Minecraft up in here, and
Tommy!
You're flipping through the wall. Wow. Oh!
My turn now!
Hope you're better than your friends.
Ow. Fucking triangle. What does triangle mean? You say it, yet you don't respond. Fuck off. Fuck
some
you.
Some kind of war, ain't ya?
What?
One step
I have to hold him. Okay.
I
like you when you're angry, you know that? That's why I keep coming back.
You mean?
Do you have any idea who you're messing with?
Same old news, gangster.
That's what I got, you son of a bitch.
Get away from me!
Oh.
You got a good right hook, I'll give you that. You're bleeding. Come up to my place. I'll take a look. Well, you gonna come in and take a load off, or what?
I'm wondering when you'd invite me up.
The bank's closed, Slugger. I'm just gonna patch you up is all. Now go sit down on the couch, roll up your sleeve. I'm getting my sewing kit. Doesn't look too bad. You need something for the pain?
No, I'm fine.
You don't have to do that.
What?
I can see it fucking hurts, Tom. You want to pretend it, don't go ask Polly to staple you up.
What do you get?
Compliments of the Don. Take another. All right. You gonna grin and bear this?
Yeah, I'll be okay.
Good. Because I don't need the little old lady next door complaining to the super about all the racket.
Just be quick about it, will ya?
Oh, it's gonna take as long as it takes. The sloppier the stitch, the uglier the scar.
That right. You stitched up a lot of fellas.
Just my father. Ma would really go after Luigi sometimes. He got pretty good at ducking dinner plates. So one day she stabbed him with her knitting needle. Right through the hand.
What for?
'Cause. She was an ugly, jealous drunk. There. Not my best work, but it'll hold.
The scar will be something to remember you by, if nothing else.
You're staying over. Can't have you stumbling through the neighborhood pie-eyed. Not when them hoods are out looking for you anyways.
Yeah, okay. You got an extra blanket or something?
No. And the heat's out.
Yes, I'll do.
Very quick, this chapter. And I'm ending it off. So, yeah, thank you all for watching. Leave a like for this episode, and I shall see you in the episode. Watch next time, man. Peace out.